Hey guys, it's your girl Tahita with Beauty and the Kinks, and I am back with another makeup tutorial for you guys today. I was inspired by the spring and the summertime since it's getting warmer out here. I just did a makeup look with a pop of color under the eye, as you can see. And so if you're interested in finding out how I created this look, just stay tuned. As always, I start off by priming my lids. I'm using Urban Decay's Primer Potion. Then I started off with a very light transition color, and because it was so light, I ended up just going over it with a warmer flesh tone color. Now I'm taking my pressed powder. I'm just using that all over my lid as a base color. By going into my outer corner with a very dark brown color. I am building the color as I go along. As I said, it's summertime, spring inspired, so I didn't want to do anything too dark, but I did want to add some depth to my crease, so I'm just building the color as I go along. Started from the outer corner, and I did start to bring that color into the crease, as you can see. And then of course I blended it all out with my blending brush. Now I'm taking a fluffy crease brush and I'm going into the crease with a dark purple color. As I said, I wanted to do something different. I'm usually with golds and browns and, you know, maroon smoky eyes. Burgundy smoky eyes. I wanted to do something different, so I said I'll just use some color this time, and I went for the purple. So I'm just taking that and I'm going into the outer corner and also dragging that into the crease and blending it all out. Next, I'm taking a shimmery beige color. It's like a tan, and I'm just putting that all over the lid, almost like reverse cut crease. I didn't cut my crease, but just doing the lid this way adds more definition to the crease area. And of course, I go back in with the purple just to blend everything out. Make sure it's not that hard of a cut crease. Now I'm just taking the same round crease brush that I had with the dark brown, and I'm adding that to the lower part of the outer crease, just adding some depth to my eye. I'm taking the original transition color, that medium brown color, and I'm just using that. And then I'm taking a flesh tone color and I'm just adding that under my brow. Initially, as with most of my looks, I don't tend to go for a thick eyeliner or winged liner. Unfortunately, it didn't work out that way. It ended up being super thick, but that's okay. I made it work. I kind of just went with it, and then I changed my mind. But I never really start off wanting to do like thick eyeliner. I try to keep it as simple as possible. But then the drama queen in me is like, nah, go for more. And I'm using Wet n Wild's, I call it a marker liner. I'm not exactly sure what the actual name of it is. I'll try to leave that in the description box. But I actually love the control that you get from these types of eyeliners. Because I use pressed powder as my base color for my lid, a lot of fallout fell on my lashes, so I'm just making sure I coat my mascara all on my lashes to make them dark again. I'm going under my eye. This is the most important part and the part that you can't see the best. I'm going under my eye with a teal color. I actually used two colors from a Sephora palette. It was a very shimmery blue and a very shimmery teal color. And that just opens up the look a little bit, opens up my eyes. brightens up the look. So I take that color from the outer corner and I bring it into the inner corner, but I ended up adding just like a shimmery white color to the inner corner just to make it pop just a bit more. I couldn't find my white eyeliner pencil, so I decided to just go ahead and do lashes until I felt like looking for it again. But yeah, I used one coat of this Maybelline mascara, and then I used another coat. I forgot the name of this. I'll try to leave it in the description box. But it just had a defining mascara because the brush is so small, it's perfect for your lower lashes. As I said, I couldn't find my white eyeliner, so I just decided to add white eyeshadow to my waterline. And this was the first time trying out the Ulta stick foundations, and the colors don't have numbers on them, they have names, and I couldn't remember what name was what color. It would have been easier, you know, if I had numbers, so I kind of was just going back and forth trying to blend these foundations. I'm just using LA Girl's Girl Conceal, and I'm using that as a highlighter. I'm just blending that all out with a damp beauty blender. Unfortunately, I did not get footage of me setting all of this, but I did set my face, and I am using a product that I got in my Ipsy bag. I believe it's called That Glow, though. It's just a highlighter stick. Pretty cool, but I gotta be extra with my highlight, so I added some Becca on top of that. Now I'm just contouring using my, or actually I think I'm just using bronzer at this point because I've already contoured. For whatever reason, I used the opposite end of my stick to pull the product from the Becca highlighter. So that's what I was doing right there. And I'm just adding a little blush. I believe that's Taj Mahal from NARS. And I'm just using NYX. I believe it's their Suede lip gloss. As I said, I'll try to leave all the information down in the description box. My memory is not helping me today at all. Color combination is really, really nice on me, I think. So I've just kind of been going with this lip because you guys know I'm usually a bright red or very dark color on the lip. So this is like my springtime go-to. And that's it. This is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys.